a special live edition of Fear Factor. Earlier today, we recruited some park guests, people just like you, to come on the show and face some of their worst fears as they perform dangerous and nasty stunts live just for you. Are you ready to meet the stars of the show? Let's bring them out right now. Here they are, your four contestants. Put your hands together. This is Jay! Neil! On my left, we've got Neil's girlfriend, Paula. And this is David. Here they are, your four contestants. Give them a big round of applause. The four of you have been chosen for one reason: to prove that you have what it takes to be a true champion of Fear Factor Live. But for that to be said, you must complete three extreme stunts that will not only test you physically, but mentally as well. If you're too afraid to attempt a stunt, you will be eliminated. If you try a stunt but fail to complete it, you're gone. But if you succeed, you will move on to the next round and that much closer to claiming the winner's bragging rights of Fear Factor Live. Are you ready to get this party started? Yeah. Over at these stairs, our crew will set you up for that first stunt. While the contestants are getting ready, let's take a look at some interviews we shot before the show and what they had to say.
Hey, my name is David. I'm all the way from Northern Ireland and then come all this way to lose.
Hi, my name is Neil. I'm from West Palm Beach. And I'm gonna win today because whatever's thrown at me, I'm willing to persevere through it.
My name is Paul. I'm from West Palm Beach, Florida, and I'm gonna win to prove my boyfriend wrong.
My name is Jay. I'm from Austin, Texas, and I'm gonna win because my daughter's gonna be in the crowd rooting me on.
Alright, that's our competitor sound before the show. But I wonder how they're feeling right about now. Just to remind everyone what they're in for.
Anyone was caught by surprise? That's a good thing. Now watch their hands. It's only a matter of time when they begin to inch their way all the way down to the end of those bars. They're very difficult to hold on to. We're at 15 seconds now.
Emma, roll that lever. Here comes that wind.
A lot of humidity in the air right now. It's going to really make it difficult to hold on. You see Paul already hands her going up and down she goes. They all want the same thing. They want to be able to choose their teammate for the next stunt. Those advantages I spoke of earlier, more times than not, will pave your way all the way to the finals as David goes down. We have a showdown now between Jay and Neil. Come on, make some noise. Let's hear it for him. Give it up there. Neil makes some adjustments in straight passes. Jay, we're giving it a good fight right now. Ever so slowly, inching to the end of those bars. Jay hoping he can hold on to one. Jay, let's go. And it is. They're up. As he sits with your middle man, a lot of times this advantage is won by just a one big bad differential. Sometimes one single miss can really cost them big. So far, two teams have found this single feedback. Jay has about a quarter's length here in front of Paula, though. That may prove to be fatal whenever that time runs out. Now we're on a quick slip. Let's hear it for the team! Over here. Five for the blue crew, five for the red team. It is a draw, therefore no advantage will be given. Hey, I love this. Very evenly matched teams here. Now for the second part of this stuff, we're going to get both 25 feet in the air.
And we're all set.
Time to start chucking cephalopods. In 3, 2, 1,
go!
The first one is the most difficult one to gauge accurately. Hitting the mark can be tough. A miss that time by the red team. You see David, he wanted to feel that swing out before he launched his first one. The first one to the air, and it's in. Oh, nice one. Now the red team, they've got some points on the board as well. It's going to come down to these last few throws. Red team waiting for a better look. We're going to be throwing this last one out for the red team. Blue team's throwing the last one. It's in. Let's hear it for our team! Not have done any better in that competition. How you feeling right now? You gotta be feeling good. You made it to the finals.
Great.
Maybe pull that down just a little bit. I can get a little feedback here. See if we can keep it from happening again. Now, I'm not gonna hear it again. Are you pretty excited now? I know you said your daughter is out here cheering you on. Is that correct?
She was the one blowing wind at us in the game.
Oh, is that right? I guess you see she's kind of like timid over there, but she's really kind of pumping you on through this competition. Now, David, I think that was a pretty good strategy. You waited for a one practice swing before we started launching those octopus. I think you got a feel for that swing. And 1, 2, 3. Three big octopus in a bucket. You got to be feeling pretty good, right?
Yeah, it feels good. I think we've got a good team effort going on there. Done with the teammates.
Well, you know that team effort's not going to matter in this last challenge. You will be battling against Jay. So do you have any final thoughts going into the finals?
Been good working with you.
Been good working with you. Anything you want to add, Jay?
The best man win.
I like that. All right, guys, like before, I want you to follow Brandon to the back. He will gear you up for that last challenge. what we've been waiting to see. Who wants it more? You got that fighting Irish spirit in David getting up that wall. You also got Jay over there.
Oh, baby.
Being cheered on by his daughter out in the audience. These guys already up to that second level. Almost like mirror images of one another right now. This is going to be a very close battle. Now they got to be very careful as they traverse across that window. Only 2 inches at the base of that window. Very easy to slide off if they're not careful.
Go, baby.
Down, as is Jay. Now they're going to make their way out to the cars here. Sometimes it's easy to lose a lot of time by just trying to get the key to the ignition. Let's see if they can get these cars started without allowing too many seconds to tick away. You can see them just up here. Oh, it sounds like the other car started at almost the exact same time, maybe just a half a second for Jay here now. And here comes the rain. Now this rain effect makes the hoods of the vehicles extremely slippery. If Jay or David slide off the front end of the car, their chances of winning are over. So they must maintain an anchor point at all times. Jay's car, once again, should be reaching its height about a half a second before David. Jay, go! David, go! It's all going to come down to who can move the fastest on the hoods of these cars. They got to move fast, but they also have to be very careful. Now making their way back to that rocket launcher. It's really in one's game still. Who's going to shoot that target first? Fireball!